Here we have verse 42 of the sixth chapter of the Gospel of John. Jesus is in a conversation with people who are in Capernaum, not far actually from his hometown, and presumably there were some people there who may have actually known Jesus in years past. Certainly the verse before us gives some intimation of that. Jesus has been commenting on the feeding of the 5,000 and made the statement that he is the bread that has come down from heaven, that if a person will partake of that bread, they will never hunger again. And of course, that's putting these people into an increasing state of mental anxiety as to try to fathom what exactly he's saying. And here we have in verse 42 something of their protest to the statement that he's just made. And it begins kai, the word for and. So and elegon, this is the third person singular, imperfect active indicative. So they were saying uk. This is the negation. It usually comes before a verb, but sometimes you'll find it in another construction as we find it here. The kai will precede a rough breather. So uk hutos. This is the demonstrative pronoun. It's the masculine singular nominative. So not this, then esten is, third person singular, present active indicative of a, me, I am. So is this one not, is the idea. Is this one not Jesus? The nominative, of course, the predicate nominative, which goes with the verb esten. So is this not Jesus? Ho huios, the son, Yosef, of Joseph. Interestingly, of course, we don't have any indication here of a knowledge of the virgin birth, and John himself doesn't insert that particular piece of information. John is silent on that topic, even though he was certainly very much aware of it, as would be perfectly obvious from his proximity to Jesus, his knowledge of Mary, etc. But it doesn't figure into the conversation here, so this particular statement is left unchallenged. Is this not the son of Joseph? And then they continue, who? This is the relative pronoun. It's the singular genitive masculine. Of whom would be the idea. And then we, and the use of the first person plural pronoun becomes emphatic because it's not strictly necessary to make sense out of the rest of the sentence. So of whom we, with an emphasis on the word we, and then oidamen. This is from oida. It means I know, usually has to do with factual information, and so that's what's going on here. Of whom we know, ton, patera, the father, kai, tain, matera, the mother. So we know the father and the mother. Some have thought this is evidence that Joseph may still at this point have been alive, since the present tense is used. It's not that we knew his father, but we know him. That is not necessarily going to follow from this. They could have been simply saying they know who that father was. The very fact that they use oidamen instead of gnoskamen would suggest something like that. So one way or another, they were certainly familiar with the apparent, ostensible, parentage of Jesus, of whom we know the father and the mother. Pos, the adverb, interrogative, how, nun, how now, lege, he says, how is it that he now says hoti, means that, ek tu urinu, how is it that he says that out of heaven, katabebeka. This is from katabino. Jesus, of course, has said that he came down, katabino, out of heaven. And so the question they're raising now is, how can he say such a thing? Katabebeka is the first person singular, perfect active indicative, that Jesus, in other words, it's quoting Jesus directly, in which he has said, I have come down and remain down, using the perfect tense, from heaven. So they're asking the question, how can this be? We know who this fellow is. We know where he grew up. We know who his parents are. What in the world can be intended by saying something like, he has come down out of heaven? So they're perplexed. And of course, they're perplexed precisely because they lack the eyes of faith. It's the point Jesus made earlier, that those that the Father has given to Jesus come to him, understand him, believe him, trust him, and of course recognize the truth of who he is.